Moscow nightclub, the opposition candidate makes her pitch to the capital's cultural elite. Russian democracy is a strange and sometimes dangerous beast.
It's a fake election.
It's a fake election?
Yes, I'm always telling that.
Explain what you mean.
I mean that like in a casino where the win is always on the house, in Russian elections the win is always on Putin's side. So I'm taking part in the elections not to win, I have no illusions about that. I'm taking part to be heard.
Once upon a time, in the former capital of the Tsars, a girl was born with a silver spoon in her mouth. When the communist empire collapsed, the chaotic transition to capitalism produced a sort of alchemy that turned silver into gold for some. Ksenia Sobchak's family was among those few. Her father, one of the founders of Russia's new democracy, became the mayor of St. Petersburg. He would later die in uncertain circumstances, while his former deputy, a once unknown KGB officer, would become the most powerful man in Russia.
He was the person who gave Putin his first job. I was a little girl then.
But by a strange twist of fate, nearly two decades later, the girl with the silver spoon would challenge the new Tsar for the highest office in the land.
По семейным вещам лично Путин очень сентиментальный человек. С брендом Собчак очень сильный. Но что не помешает ее снять, если он почувствует угрозу?
Miles south of Moscow, the city of Kursk, Ksenia Sobchak is on the campaign trail. Her task here is to show that she can speak to ordinary Russians too.
The biggest problem in Russia is not freedom of speech, unfortunately for many people. It's the poverty.
Out in the suburbs, residents have been complaining they can't get their children into a local nursery.
20 километров.
Но есть закон такой на
с грудным ребенком. Таксисту 250 рублей в один конец.
Слушай, есть же закон. Ну давайте попробуем помочь человеку. Ну что значит? Ну как?
Now she's haranguing some local officials. This is pretty much the kind of thing that Putin does when he goes around the region.
Ну а как вы думаете вообще?
А мы думаем.
Что думает она, самое главное?
Да, что думает она? И что она, что она нам даст именно? Вот что она нам
что
даст?
Что вы хотите?
Мы пенсионерам. Она... Нам?
Да.
Да, что мы пенсионерам.
Ну хотя бы по 20 тысяч было пенсии. Да. Вот что мы хотим.
А сколько сейчас пенсии?
10.
10 тысяч.
А у некоторых 8.
Вот. How do you feel like people react to you coming as you do from quite a privileged background?
You know, I don't try to be like I'm like one of you because, well, it's not true. If I wear red lipstick in my everyday time, why should I go without makeup to them? It's not kind of true. I'm not a populist. So yes, I come on in good car and in a good clothes, but I own this money. I didn't steal them.
Corruption is a big issue in this election for all candidates. After a slightly optimistic welcome at local campaign headquarters, Ksenia takes things one step further.
Нет, вы верите, что по налоговой декларации, которую мы все сдавали как кандидаты, я получаюсь примерно чтобы не ошибиться, в 5 раз богаче Путина. Ну вы в это верите? Вот мы слышим же смех. Как так может быть? Так не может быть, потому что это вранье.
In Russian politics there are certain red lines. Among them Putin and his inner circle.
Are you saying Putin is corrupt?
I say that Putin created a system that allows those people to get funds from the state.
Direct criticism of Putin feels dangerous. And out on the streets, many people simply don't want to know.
Здравствуйте. Я из Англии. Я... Crazy. As soon as you approach people, they run away.
But Sobchak's journey to dissidence has been an unusual one.
When money gets into my hands, I spend everything. Clothes is where my budget stays. It's a lot. It's about $3,000-$4,000 a month. I really like this sweater.
In the first decade of this century, as millions of Russians struggled, Ksenia Sobchak transformed herself from society rich kid to TV celebrity. Feeding the masses a diet of reality television and branding herself simply Ksenia. But then the girl with the silver spoon had another transformation. In 2011, she joined opposition protests and was promptly carted off to a police cell. Alexei Navalny, the movement's leader, has long been a thorn in the Kremlin's side.
I was close with him all those years. We shared many values and we are still sharing those values, I hope.
But when Navalny was banned from standing in this year's elections and Ksenia announced she was running instead, his supporters called her a traitor. Ksenia, they said, is a Kremlin agent. Her campaign, just more reality TV. Could it be that Ksenia Sobchak is doing the Kremlin's bidding? I paid a visit to her campaign headquarters to meet one of her top advisors, a woman well versed in the darker arts of Russian politics. She should be. She used to work for Putin himself.
Конечно, Собчак привлекает большое внимание к выборам, а это главное, что хотел Кремль. Они хотели найти кандидатов, которые привлекут внимание к выборам, но не будут опасными для Путина.
Чтобы повысить явку?
Повысить явку, да, потому что им кажется, что легитимность выборов Путина держится на явке.
Just to be clear, this is Sobchak's own campaign advisor saying, yes, we're playing the Kremlin's game. But in Russia, there's always more than one game going on.
Понятно, что устраивается какой-то спектакль, и вы можете сказать, фу, это спектакль неинтересный, нечестный, я не буду в нем участвовать, потому что все правила нечестные, и все не так. Но всегда есть возможность включиться в этот спектакль и попробовать сыграть там свою роль.
Я думаю, там много желающих.
And that's exactly what Sobchak says she's trying to do. If there's one thing Ksenia understands, it's the power of television. She's using her candidacy to talk about issues that are taboo.
Мы нарушили договоренности международные, мы нарушили договор с Украиной. Мы, по сути дела, взяли и напали на нашего младшего соседа.
To say this on state TV is heresy, genuinely subversive. Shocked presenters have resorted to surreal measures to try to drown her out. But here's the conundrum. The Kremlin controls everything. Who gets to stand in elections and who goes on TV. So what is going on? Ksenia treads a delicate path. Before she set out on her journey, the girl with the silver spoon needed to get the approval of the Tsar in the Kremlin. She needed wise counsel.
И где-то в конце августа она пришла ко мне и сказала, я решила, я иду. Как ты думаешь, я ему должна сказать или нет? Я ей сказал, ты что думаешь, он не знает? Ты думаешь, наши разговоры не записаны? Ты думаешь, ему не доложили?
Алексей Венедиктов is one of Russia's most famous and well-connected journalists.
Конечно, надо идти, но не просить разрешения, а поставить в известность. Так сказать, я решила идти и посмотреть реакцию.
As it happens, Ksenia is in the process of making a film about her father, the former mayor of St. Petersburg. Putin, who'd been his deputy, had agreed to an interview. So, in September, she went to see him in the Kremlin.
And then in the end, I said this, that, you know, I took this decision and I just want you to know that I'm going to challenge you. And he was like silent for a second and said, well, it's your decision, but it's also your responsibility.
What do you think he meant by that?
Well, I don't want even to think about that. I don't think anything nice.
And so the Tsar decided to accept his challenger. But not everyone was happy. Behind the facade of monolithic power, different factions struggled for control.
В Кремле были разные мнения, я знаю. Один очень высокий чиновник в Кремле, сказал мне, ты понимаешь, все думали, что это плюшевая девочка, игрушка, кукла, Барби. И сейчас они ходят, говорят, мы же вам говорили, зачем вы ее выпустили, это Франкенштейн. И вот теперь мы имеем человека, который критикует коррупцию и Путина лично. Человека, который говорит о том, что мы должны уйти с Украины. Человек, который говорит, что Крым не наш. Как это может быть?
How indeed? How did the girl who spoke out against the Tsar get permission to run against him? The answer to this riddle lies buried in the past, when Putin worked for Ksenia's father in St. Petersburg.
Это замечательный музей становления демократии в России имени Анатолия Александровича Собчака.
Or perhaps it should more accurately be titled The Museum of How Russian Democracy Was Poisoned at Source. The name Anatoly Собчак stands alongside the likes of Gorbachev and Yeltsin.
Сердцем. Это Собчак.
А тут у нас знакомое лицо.
Да-да-да, он там сзади. Он никогда не высовывался вперед.
The story of how the anti-Soviet reformer chose an obscure KGB officer as his deputy is also the story of how factions from the old Soviet security establishment have come to be running Russia today.
Надо знать, что Собчак ненавидел просто все КГБ. Он ненавидел этих, которые...
Но почему он тогда нанял Путина?
Я думаю, от безысходности.
Роковое решение для России.
Наверное.
Anatoly Собчак was voted out of office in 1996 amid allegations of corruption. When investigators called him in for questioning, Putin helped spirit him out of the country.
Вы знаете, как человек, как товарищ, как друг, он очень надежный.
But in Moscow, factions were maneuvering. Putin was being groomed as Yeltsin's successor. The battle was over who would have sway over the new leader. Then, in February 2000, Anatoly Собчак died suddenly at the age of 62. At the funeral, Russia's new president was distraught.
That was the first and last time everyone saw him crying in Russia. All this day, I still remember it, and one of the shock I had is his reaction. He was totally killed by this.
But what killed Собчак? To this day, that remains a mystery. The original autopsy was inconclusive, and many were suspicious, including Собчак's widow, Ksenia's mother.
Я хочу очень прямо спросить один вопрос.
Да, попробуйте.
Вы думаете, что вашего супруга убили?
Не знаю. Врагов у него было много, и они никуда не делись. Те люди, которые считали, что они способствуют приходу Путина во власть, и могли рассчитывать на то, что Собчак им может мешать, потому что единственным авторитетом, который был бы для Путина, это был Собчак.
Нарусова had her own autopsy performed, but instead of making the results public, she keeps them locked in a safe in a secret location.
Но эти документы, о которых вы говорите,
они есть
за границей.
Конечно.
Но это значит, что это у вас какая-то страховка?
Считайте так.
Почему?
Вы знаете, жить в нашей стране страшно, поэтому боюсь.
The Kremlin today is still a place of rival factions. To threaten their power is to take a terrible risk. The girl with the silver spoon is not a girl anymore. Her family history may protect her, but only up to a point.
В Кремле 22 башни, я имею в виду кремлевские башни, на самом деле. На самом деле в Кремле всегда есть несколько партий, которые по-разному оценивают, как вести кампанию. Конечное слово принадлежит президенту. И надо признать, что, безусловно, без решения президента Ксению не снимут. Но могут убить, например, случайно.
Meanwhile, back on the Sobchak campaign trail.
Ну что, людей пустите только в трамвай, ребят, вначале, а то, знаете, мы все это...
From public transport to pensions to childcare, Ksenia listens to people's everyday problems as if she were a real candidate in a real election.
А почему они выходят? Они маршрут один убрали сюда, и все.
То есть просто взяли и отменили, правильно?
The passengers on the Kursk trolley bus know all about Ksenia's family ties. And yet...
Это настоящая позиция, я к ней симпатия отношусь, она молодец. Не каждая молодая женщина так смело выступит со своими вопросами.
А вы за нее будете голосовать?
Ну, я подумаю еще.
Пары не выходим. Видите, они как вас любят, Ксения Анатольевна.
Я вас так люблю, Тимур. Я понял. До свидания, хорошего вам дня. До свидания.
What then is the purpose of all this elaborate theater? If Ksenia is a threat to the regime, why let her run at all? I've spoken to a senior government official on condition that I couldn't quote them by name. I said, what's the point of having an election when everyone acknowledges that only one person can win? And they said, look, this is a Western invention that you have. We don't have a classical democracy in Russia. We have what they called a developing democracy. The truth is, Russian democracy has stopped developing. It's frozen, paralyzed by two certain facts. Just as surely as Putin will win the next election, he will also not be around forever.
Вокруг Путина сейчас существует несколько группировок, каждая из которых готовит своего преемника. Но проблема именно в том, что этих группировок слишком много стало. И все они довольно сильные. Путин, он как вот ствол у дерева, как бы на которое все нанизано. Не будет Путина, и все развалится.
Behind the walls of the Kremlin, powerful people are playing games. Ksenia Sobchak is a pawn. Some factions are pushing her forward, others want to hold her back. The girl with the silver spoon knows all this, but she thinks the pawn just might become a queen.
That's my chess game. I played this option of going to elections because I was thinking that I have a chance to go through because of my name, because they underestimate me, because I have a past which they can always punch on me, because they're not afraid of me as much as Navalny. So these are my chances.
Who's the better chess player, you or Putin?
I don't know, we will see in the end. But the end is not near because I'm only starting.